All right, a governor who dealt with this firsthand, because in his little state, and it's a wonderful state as a former resident there, of Rhode Island, he was overseeing it. Donald Carcieri, the former governor of the fine state of Rhode Island. And everyone thinks, governor, when that kind of thing happens, it is the end of the world. We avoided that federally this time. What is your message for next time?
Well, I think that there's a lot of confusion right now, Neil. I think you can't shut down. We tried to go through that at the state level. It's even complicated there because who's essential, who's not essential. It's very, very confusing. Nobody wants to feel as though they're non-essential. I think the issue here really is, what is the basis on which we're having a shutdown? I think the public is not really keenly aware yet of what's the issue we're fighting about. Is it spending? If it's spending, what are the issues in spending that we're fighting about?
Well, did you suffer
for the shutdown
in Rhode Island? Did you suffer for that? Did people blame you, Republicans, for forcing the issue, Democrats for hat in hand being part of the issue? What happened?
Well, I think what happened is we started to get on the process of laying off people and then deciding who needed to be shut down. The unions came in and said, this is really not the right thing to do. And I agreed with them. I said, what we needed was the concessions in terms of pensions and health care, co-shares, all of those things, Neil, so that we could get the costs under control. I think once we got to that point, everybody agreed the best thing would be, rather than furlough people or shut down the state government, everybody took a pay cut. We had 8 furlough days, which meant people worked but weren't paid. That was essentially a 3% pay cut for all the state employees.
But that wasn't enough to cover everything, right?
No, it wasn't. But a lot of different pieces in state budgets, and the federal budget's not a lot different. In state budgets, it's people and benefits, it's Medicaid, and then it's the issue of the money that the states send to the local communities. I think in Wisconsin, for example, that what's getting lost in the whole issue in Wisconsin for Governor Walker is that he knows he's going to have to reduce local aid. And so he's got to give those municipalities the tools so they right. can adjust their cost. And that's okay. why he's trying to get these contracts undone. But that message hasn't gotten through. And as you know, and I know from the union standpoint, it's really at the end of the day all about the dues money.
Okay. How's retirement treating you, by the way? Because it looks like you've gone Hollywood.
Once you've been in this, you know you kind of never get it out of your blood, Neil. And
right.
I'm really worried about the country right now. I've heard your previous speakers and your guests. I mean, this is a huge issue. 2012 was a real budget. I don't know what the end game is right now for the White House.
Well, we're a long way.
This is
You're
all
right.
a game on the showdown.
Many more.
At the end of the day. Yeah, many, many more. We can't even okay. pay the interest on our debt right now without borrowing the money. Think about right. that. When they take your mortgage payment and put it in the principal, that's what the nation is doing right now.
Right. You're right. You're right, Governor. Thank you. Good seeing you again.
My pleasure, Neil. Take care.
All right.